Hello everyone, welcome back. As you may already know, I'm reacting to Lana Del Rey's discography because I've never listened to it before. So, we're officially on her second studio album called Ultraviolence, and I'm very excited to dive in. There, I'm listening to the deluxe version. There are 15 songs. We're gonna jump right in. If you wanna watch my previous reaction to Born to Die and the Paradise edition of Born to Die, go watch them first. Let's just get started. The first song is called Cruel World. Also, I'm wearing my glasses today because I'm always squinting to see the song titles, and I realized when I was editing that I'm always like this. So. Two things to note really quickly before we continue. In the last two reactions, I talked about how she's always has religious meanings or metaphors or mentions of religious things in her songs. And she's always talking about how she's crazy or how she's a bad girl. And she already has done both of those two things in this first song. So let's keep going and see where we're headed with this. Pausing quickly to say that so far sonically, I really, really like this song. It's sounding a little bit repetitive, but it's a 6.5 minute song, so, you know, there's a few choruses in there. But overall, so far. That was Cruel World, and I really liked it. Like I said before, sonically, it was very good. I loved the music and her voice in it. I liked it. We're off to a good start. The next song is called Ultraviolence. Also, in my Born to Die reaction, there were a few songs I mentioned that I knew, but I was looking over the track list before I listened to this album, and I'm pretty sure I don't know any of these songs. So that's exciting. Here we go, Ultraviolence. Cute nickname. She's saying he hit her and it felt like a kiss. Let's keep listening.
He used to call me poison, and that was poison ivy.
Heaven is on earth.
I love you the first time. I love you the last time. Yo soy la princesa. Comprende these white lines. Cause I'm your jazz singer. And you're my cult leader. I love you forever. I love you forever.
Is Lana Latina? I didn't know she spoke Spanish. She might not even speak Spanish, but she just sang in Spanish. Wow. That was Ultraviolence. And when I have seen the title of this album, I didn't realize that, like, she was talking about actual violence. Overall, that song seemed really sad and, like, probably a lot of people's reality. But I thought it was interesting that the song is called Ultraviolence and she talks about violence, but then she says she can hear violins. I think that's a nice little play on words there. But beautiful song, sonically. That was so good. Okay, the next song is called Shades of Cool. She's singing about me. Blue eyes, lives in California. Well, I don't live in California right now, but I'm from California. I don't drive a Chevy Malibu though.
He drives a Chevy Malibu, and when he calls for me, not for you.
She sounded like Snow White in that chorus.
Women do, I'm one of many.
Wow, Shades of Cool. Unreal. That was so excellent. So far, we're 3 for 3. I'm loving this album so far. I want to just jump right into the next one. It's called Brooklyn Baby. Brooklyn Baby, you guys, we're 4 for 4. These have all been excellent. And they're all long. There hasn't been a single song under 4 minutes yet. We're going on to the next song called West Coast. I think this one's a popular one from the album. Sorry. That was loud. Ooh. How it slows down from that pre-chorus to the chorus. Ooh, baby, West Coast. I feel like I'm saying even less through these songs than I was on Born to Die, because I am just soaking them all in. This is exactly the kind of sound I love from Lana. And we're 5 for 5. Let's keep going. Let's see how long this streak is gonna last. The next song is called Sad Girl, and it's another 5 minute song. Saying his Bonnie on the side, quite clever, because on the side rhymes with Clyde. So I think this is a little, you know, trick she's playing with the wording. She's always talking about she's a bad girl. I know you Lana fans are probably gonna be upset by this, but that is definitely a TikTok audio. All right, that was Sad Girl. If you guys can tell, I loved that one as well. So we're 6 for 6, which is insane. I usually start to lose interest. Not interest, but I, you know, there's usually a miss from every artist at this point. So let's keep going to track 7, Pretty When You Cry.
All the pretty stars shine for you, my love. Am I that girl that you dream of? I do, 'cause I'm pretty when I cry. I'm pretty when I cry. I'm pretty when I cry. I'm pretty when I cry.
We're 7 for 7. That was probably my least favorite of the seven so far, but I still really, 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 really liked it. So, let's keep this streak going. The next song is called Money, Power, Glory. I am loving this album so far. I also want money. We talked about this in the last video, but it's just funny hearing the word dope. That was Money, Power, Glory. I can't decide if it's an 8 for 8 or if that... I didn't love that one, to be honest with you. I felt like it was a little too repetitive for my liking. But I loved it sonically. I don't know. I'm gonna say that that one was a skip. Not a skip, necessarily. But it just wasn't, like, the best. Next song is called F'd My Way Up to the Top. Awesome. She's always got a weird accent on some words. What I do the best. You got nothing, I got tested, and I'm best, yes. Lay me down. Well, that one was, if the last one wasn't a skip, then this one was for me. I, again, really liked it sonically, but also very repetitive, and I don't know, just something about it wasn't clicking with me. I gotta go to the bathroom, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. The next song is called Old Money.
Blue hydrangea. Red racing cars, sunset and vine. The kids were young and pretty. It's the girl you.
That one once. I loved that song. If the other two were misses, this was back on track to before. This is actually one of my favorites on the album so far. That was so good. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Okay, the next song is called The Other Woman, which she's referred to herself as on this album already, so might be about her.
The other woman has time to manicure nails. The other woman is perfect wherever fails, and she's never seen
This sounds like a really old song. Maybe it's another cover. We'll find out at the end. Stans are gonna hate me again, but another TikTok audio. Okay, so I did research. Jessie Mae Robinson is the writer of that song, and this is another 40s or 50s song sung by Lana, and I just wanted to do a full cover album of these 50s songs because she sounds so good singing this old-timey music. I don't know. Anyways, that was incredible. Another one I loved, very close to the top. Probably in my top three of the album so far. Next song is called Black Beauty.
I have a darker shade of brown, 'cause you like your women Spanish, dark, strong, and proud. Paint the sky black. You said if you could have your way, you'd make a nighttime or a day.
Is Lana Spanish? I don't know.
So it suits the mood of your soul. Oh, what can I?
Or is she just being a culture vulture? Beautiful song. I like seriously don't have anything to say because these songs are all so good. And I liked Born to Die, but I love Ultraviolet so far. And there's still three more songs. So the next song is Guns N' Roses.
Heavy metal. I should have learned to let you stay. You didn't want me all the time, but you were worth it anyway. 'Cause you were so much better. You loved Guns N' Roses. Guns N' Roses. You loved
Game Boy. Game Boy. Like you got game, but it sounds like you got a Game Boy. Electric guitar in the back of that one was so good. But anyways, that was Guns N' Roses, and it was another excellent track. I am loving these songs. The next one is Florida Kilos. Let's go. This song sounds like a Florida song.
Speaking about on the stove, looking up a dream.
Is this the song from the other album, Yayo? And I learned what it meant. I'm going to look to see if it was called Yayo. It was. She's singing about cocaine, which I knew from the title, it's quite obvious, but that's interesting. Dope. That lyric, you like your lady like you like your drinks, cool. White lines, pretty daddy, go skiing, you snort it like a champ, like the winter we're not in. Come on down to Florida. All right, that was Florida Kilos. Absolutely the worst song on the album. But it also was pretty catchy, I'm not gonna lie. All right, guys, we made it to the last song. It's called Is This Happiness? And I'm excited. Sad that the album's ending, but excited to listen to this last one.
No cheap thrills, you're a hard man to love and numb. A hard woman to keep track of. You like to, you want your way. You make me so mad, got you.
Closing track, very sad. Seems like some suicidal stuff is happening, but wow. All right, my outro's gotta be pretty quick because my battery's blinking that it's about to die. But thank you guys for watching. Give this video a like, subscribe if you'd like. I'm not forcing you to do it, but overall, this album was excellent. I loved it. This was like incredible. I will be listening to this all the time now. I don't know what my favorites were. I need to like listen to it more, but I just remember loving Ultraviolence. I think Ultraviolence was like my favorite. All of them are so good. Okay, my battery's gonna die, so bye.